effectively aggregate logs in your Kubernetes-centric environment with popular open source and modern technology, look no further than Grafana Loki. Join me today as we navigate the first step of getting started, installing Grafana Loki, a renowned log aggregation service, on Kubernetes. The setting: Google Kubernetes Engine. Our tool: Helm. This acclaimed duo represents the gold standard when it comes to efficiently installing Grafana Loki. So, if you're ready to take a focused leap into log aggregation, let's dive in. Our journey starts with a new Google Cloud project. First on our to-do list is opening up the Kubernetes Engine page and enabling the API. But before we actually provision a cluster, let's preview the installation plan. The Grafana Loki documentation is extensive, but we'll focus in on the section covering installation with Helm. The simpler, monolithic Loki is our installation of choice today. However, those keen on a more scalable Loki installation will find the process very similar. In any case, your installation assets are fully open source and available on GitHub. For simplicity, each installation command can be ran in the Google Cloud Shell once the cluster is ready. Our strategy for the cluster? Relying on the autopilot approach, where Google handles a lot of the complex management and configuration. However, the instructions remain consistent for those preferring the standard cluster approach. Just keep in mind that node pool design will be your responsibility. Our cluster is almost operational and our Cloud Shell terminal awaits configuration. We'll need a values file for our Helm installation, and we'll stick with a single replica of Loki. Once our cluster is up and ready, we can complete the installation. Deploying Loki into a namespace other than the default is ideal. Before submitting, let's not forget to authenticate our kubectl client with the new cluster. Let's look through the resources brought to life by the Helm installation. The Loki setup includes pods managed by a daemon sets, stateful sets, and deployments across the instance itself, canaries, gateway, and agent operator. One final step, verifying Loki health using the ready endpoint. A port forward to our Loki service maps port 8080 to 3100, making our endpoint visible via web preview. We'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions. Thanks for watching, and as always, please enjoy responsibly.